So if you are part of any church ministry or any sort of online ministry right now, you know that these are obviously crazy times that we're all in, because most churches are forced to be online only, as we are as well at our church. So for the last 4 months, about, I think 19 straight weeks, we've been producing our services week by week, and our company Scaling Creative has helped Faith Church in Allentown to produce their services week by week, which is awesome to be a part of. And because my channel is all about behind the scenes and kind of showing you a little bit about what we do, I wanted to give you a behind the scenes tour of how we make church happen each and every week. Thursday night is the night that we actually do everything. So the sermon, the worship, all the intros and outros, they all get filmed on Thursday. And then half of the stuff we edit as Scaling Creative. And then the other half they actually put together, and it's kind of filmed in real time, like the sermon and the actual worship. So that's like a multicam production. And then we do the intros and the outros, which we'll show you later in this video. And we edit them and send that to the church on Friday. Everything's uploaded on Saturday, and Sunday morning it actually gets published. So here's a look behind the scenes at how we make it happen. I hope this is helpful. Feel free to comment below if you have any questions at any point. We're here to help. Let's go inside and make it happen. So our normal setup for the sermon is actually two C200s. And we use a 70 to 200 lens on one and an 85 on the other. So this is not the normal setup that's actually here for the church on a regular basis, but ever since COVID and we've kind of helped them produce the Sunday video service each week, we've just been using our cameras for the sermon. They look really, really, really good. So we've really liked to use them, and they just got a bunch of new cameras at the church, but they haven't gotten them yet. So we've been using these for the last bunch of months. They've been working really, really well. So we normally have them right in the dead center of the room. So unlike normal, where it's back there, we're setting up the risers now in the dead middle of the room so that we can just have a really nice focal length and make it look great. So part one is the sermon. We get here around 3:45, set everything up, and the sermon filming happens at 4:30. That's what's happening first. Okay, so the sermon is wrapped up. Next thing we do is actually record the intros and outros for the service. Normally on a Sunday, we would have someone come up on stage and just welcome people and make people feel obviously welcome and introduce themselves and the church and all that stuff. And obviously on an online service, you don't really get to do that from just the music starting or something like that. So we end up having a little intro that we do. That way they can have someone come on screen before the main worship comes on. So we always film these separately. So that's what we're gonna go do now. I will typically use a boom pole and my Shep's microphone for audio. That way we don't have to lab anybody up. We can just get it sounding great.
Which way are we facing? Toward this way?
You want to use that?
No, I'll use that as well. You're gonna need a lot of light to, you need a lot of light to not overexpose the, all right. Here, Pablo, his headphones.
Thank you very much.
More than that, or is that about right?
Definitely a little more.
More?
If I may, yeah.
One important thing that I've talked about before is make sure that you always, always turn a camera off or your audio source off on anything that you're using phantom power for. You don't want to plug in or remove an XLR cable when phantom power is on. It can really damage the microphone. So if you're running it into a camera like we are with the C200, you should always turn off the camera first. And if you're going to an audio recorder, you should turn off the audio recorder. There's a center point of gravity in absolutely everything. The key is to find it.
I just think the other thing.
How'd that sound? So whenever we're doing any of these intros and outros or this kind of thing where it's like a one camera setup, because we don't normally deliver in 4K, this is always delivered in 1080 to them. We actually film it all in 4K, so it allows us to crop in, which is really convenient because then they don't have to do a flawless take. It allows us to crop in and have what feels like multiple angles, but we don't actually have to have multiple angles set up. In this kind of intro, they're talking to the camera so that the person feels like they're obviously brought into the building. So you don't really want like a side angle or some other shot that's not kind of that personal feel of them looking into the camera. So the 4K crop works really well because you don't have to set up another camera, but you still get the same purpose, which
is pretty important. So that's what we do. So we shoot it in 4K. We always try to find spots that there's different light or unique lighting. Sometimes we'll bring in lighting, sometimes we use natural light. It really depends. We change it up almost every week because we've been doing it for 4 months, so we just kind of always are looking for something different to do. Also, because a lot of people ask, the shotgun mic that we use is actually a Sheps MK41. This mic is literally my favorite mic that I've ever owned, and I use it also even in music because it's so, so good. This capsule specifically was referred to me by someone who does boom op stuff like professionally for all sorts of TV networks and movies. He's like super legit. He referred this mic to me maybe a year ago and I got it, and it's my absolute favorite mic in the world. It sounds incredible. It is so good at actually capturing directly what's in front of the mic and literally disregarding even reverb and things that are in the room. It just captures things so, so clear and so well. And I could not recommend it enough. It's relatively expensive. It's about $1,700 for this mic, but honestly, it is the best thing ever. If you do a lot of audio work, like people on screen talking, interviews, and all that kind of thing, I would not recommend anything higher than this. See ya. And normally for interviews and things, I would put this on a boom stand and not hold it the whole time, but because we do these kind of things every week and it's usually 20 seconds, 30 seconds per take, I just hold it. And it just is easier that way instead of bringing another whole stand. And it's kind of fun to be a boom operator anyway, because it's like I don't get to do it very often. I think it'd be super fun. Wireless comm and wireless camera. Ooh, baby. Okay, so we wrapped up the sermon. We wrapped up the sermon intros, and now we are getting ready to film worship. This is Caleb. Caleb calls all the shots here for the actual switchers and all that kind of stuff. So, Caleb, tell us about what our setup is on a regular Thursday here.
Yeah, so as the director, I'm in charge of 8 cameras. We run an 8 camera production here. And what I'm looking for in doing that is what's happening on stage and capturing that and bringing the experience of the room to the people at home. And that's crucial now more than ever because of, you know, the whole COVID thing. People are all at home and there's nobody in the room. So it's really important to capture that.
Yeah.
Here in the church.
Yep. A lot of our positions right now are a little different than they actually were when people in the room. So we're still kind of figuring out exactly where like final positions go, because we have the flexibility during this time to walk and do anything we want because there's nobody here, but it's obviously not like that when the room is full. So we have cameras at a bunch of different positions. This is the only wireless camera. This one is camera 6, which we run on the side of the stage here. We get some really nice tight shots as we're kind of maneuvering around. I love this little rig. It's nice. Wireless comm and wireless receiver straight to the thing. So this is something they just got and it works really well. Nate is the director and in charge of everything tech at the church. So we were just walking through the rig. Tell us about this little rig.
So this is a Teradek Bolt. So it allows us to transmit full HD signal at no latency up to 500 feet, which is pretty incredible. And it just allows all the flexibility so you can literally walk wherever you need to walk without worrying about tripping over cables.
Yeah, which is awesome.
Plugging anything in or something breaking or any other issues, which is awesome.
Yeah, one thing we've been trying to work on a lot is we previously didn't have a lot of camera operators. So one thing we've obviously started to introduce more during this time is more physical people actually manning the cameras. And so we're going to start doing a lot more training and a lot of actual recruiting for more people. Because even if you have 8 cameras, if they're all just static and on tripods, the shots obviously get pretty boring pretty fast. So we've been able to start having more and more people operating them and now training them. And we're going to try to get like 2 rigs similar to this, like on the ground, so that we can have flexibility with these and then have a bunch of other shots on tripods getting, you know, the main action and all that. So it's coming together though. We're forced into changing everything. As soon as this happened, he got here in the first week. He was here at the church on staff, was COVID. So he hasn't even attended or led during an actual live in-person event, which
not
is crazy.
Yet, but we'll make it happen.
Yeah.
And when the in-person ones come around, it'll be great.
The good thing about it is it's forced us to, and allowed us actually to like start to really implement video things faster than we probably even thought about, because it's like, hey, by the way,
this would have never happened otherwise.
We're online only, so we need to make that better. So.
Sorrow comes. Go, three.
Chorus.
Three's in. Ready, eight. Eight's in. Set seven. Dissolve seven. Set four. Dissolve four. Set two. Dissolve two. Set seven. Dissolve seven. Set eight. Dissolve eight. Okay. Set four. Dissolve four. Set two. Dissolve two. Set three, go three. Three's in. Set seven, dissolve seven. Set four, dissolve four. Set six, dissolve six. Set eight, dissolve eight. Set seven, dissolve seven. Set four, dissolve four. Set two, dissolve two. Set seven, dissolve seven. Set six, dissolve six. Set eight, dissolve eight. Set four, dissolve two. Four. Set seven, dissolve seven. Set eight, dissolve eight. Set six, dissolve six. Set four, dissolve four. Set five, dissolve five. Set seven, dissolve seven. Set three and go. Three, dissolve three. Set four, dissolve four. Set two, dissolve two. Set seven, take seven. Ready, eight. Take eight. Ready, one. Ready, seven. Take seven. Ready, four. And go, four. Four's in. Ready, two. Two's in. Ready, seven. Take seven. Set six. Dissolve six. Ready, one. Take one. Ready two, take two. Ready seven, take seven. Ready eight, take eight. Ready four, take four. Ready seven, take seven. Ready three, go three. And set three, dissolve three.
So that's kind of a look behind the scenes at what a service looks like. It's about a 5-hour Thursday for myself and the team, and everything went good. But if you're still watching this video in general, you're pretty special. So thanks for watching. Comment below, tell me what you liked. See you soon.